Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. And if you have already watched my previous tutorials or videos, thank you so much for coming back. Today I would like to share how I made this 4-strand bracelet. And to make this, I used a backward braided alpha technique that made by Amber Ray on Instagram has made. I already explained the same thing when I made the tutorial for this 2-strand braid. And she made the bracelet with 3-strand braid in the middle. And I was inspired by that. So I tried with the 2-strand. And then today I tried with the 4-strand. And the principle is the same. And just because we use 4-strand, the order of crossing is a little different, but that's about it. So, okay, so let's get started. Okay, so let's start. And first thing you have to make sure is that there are 8 threads, and then the lead string is on the left side. You first knot from left to right, and then this the row from left to right, we do always the same thing. And for these three, and for these three, we do just knotting. And we just use the center two to make a cross. So first, we do these, we make knots on these three strings. Then, so instead of the regular forward knot, we pass the lead string under the base string, and then this one pass inside here from the top, and then pull to the right. Do it again. So we pass the lead string under like this, and then pass through. Do exactly the same thing for the second and the third base string from the left. Four, under, pass it through, one more time. Make sure that the one from the right pass under, under, and then we do this. Pass it through, pull to the right, because we're going from left to right. The same thing for the third piece string. Okay, so now for the center two, you can see that that comes out of the cross of the one before. So you make sure that the right one goes over the left one. So always the cross is from right top to left bottom over the other base string. Here. So basically it's like this on the top. So we knot, make a knot on the one which is over the lead string. So this one, this base string goes
over the lead string. And then we pass it through from the top to the right. And then just raise the bass string a little to make sure that it made a nice knot close here. And now the one which we didn't touch, which is under this, we make a knot. I just put this aside. Make sure again, always make sure that the lead string is under and pass it through. And here, of course, there's this little excessive part, so just gently push so that it doesn't leave any space. And again, just showing it clearly one more time here, so it comes out from here and then go like this and then put it inside here. The cross. Now we made one cross here. Okay. And now we just make a knot on these three threads on the very right. So, like this. And I'm doing it slowly because I found it very tricky. Until I kind of understood. Okay. So when it comes out from the right, make sure that it passes under the bass string, under, and then pass it through. And I'm sorry, these bass strings are not really new one. I used the scrap threads to upcycle, so it's not really, it's like the tearing apart. And I hope it's not too hard for you to see what's going on. Did exactly the same thing for the left three and the right three, and I'm just finished the row from left to right. So now we go from right to left, and the first two, the same thing which we did, because they are always the border. And just the different direction of the knots. So we made a four under the bass string from left to right. Now we make a kind of B. So. Like this. So now this is the lead string is under this string, and then we pass it through from the top. And make this knot nice and smooth. And now we just pull from the left, pass it under, make the little B here. Second one, we do the same thing. This is how I do. I just put like the finger here so that it's easier to pass through the lead string and pull. Again, the lead string is under the bass string. Put the finger here and pass it through. Now we do the cross part. Just put this aside. Put actually the left, this left one to on the side so that it's easier to see. So first we make the cross with the third and fourth one from the right. And then the direction is of the cross is opposite. So now left one goes over the right one. So it's opposite from what we did from left to right. We did. So the left one is on top of the right one. And then we knot first from the left one, which is on top of the right one. So same rule. Like this. So under here. Just show one more time. You see? Now it's making a space here, so make sure there's a big space. And then pass under like this. Now we have the bass string, which we didn't touch, which is under the knot we just made. So I have to make the knot on this one. So make sure have the position. This kind of just gently push up, not to make a space. And then do it one more time. So we just pull from the left. So we just gently do this. Then there you go. So we just finish one cross from right to left. Now there are four strings left. Let's just put these four aside. And now for the next two, we do exactly the same thing. So the left one on top of the right one. Like this. Make a cross. And hold the lead string, make sure. So, yes, and then put it through from the top. Thank you. which we just didn't touch. Maybe the bass string, do the same thing. So. Under the bass string and then put it on the top. More time. Make sure there's no space. Yes. And now the last two. We do the same thing without crossing. So. Back to the beginning, and we just repeat these two rows, the pattern, all the way until the desired length. Okay, so it's done. So after I knotted until the desired length, about 14 centimeters, I finished in a kind of triangle end, but just a reverse knot. So there were 8 knots on each thread when you finish knotting, and then the next one is 6 knots. So make 1 knot on the 2 threads on the both sides, and then 1 each on the threads in between, and then you make 1 knot on 3 threads, and then make 1 knot on the center 2, and then the last knot on the 3 threads again. That will make 4 knots. And then the next one, you make 2 knots, 4 threads on each. And then the last knot on 8 threads. And then I made a wrap knot and finish with 2 braids. Twisted braids. Yes. So I hope you enjoy watching and making it too. And so thank you so much for watching. And hope to see you soon.